In the last video, we talked about decomposing a vector in an orthogonal or in an orthonormal basis. And this is very closely related to the idea of projecting one vector onto another. So the notion is, let's suppose we have a vector x, and we want to break x up into two pieces. We want to break x up into a piece that's in the v direction, and I'm going to call that piece x parallel, and a piece that is perpendicular to the v direction, and I'm going to denote that x perp. The question is, if you're given x and v, how can you figure out what is x parallel and what is x perp? And the key is to use inner products. You see, x parallel has to be some multiple of v. It's in the same direction as v, so it's just some number c times v. So we write x as a constant times v, that's x parallel, plus x perp. And then we take the inner product of v with both sides. So the inner product of v with x is a c times the inner product of v with v, plus the inner product of v with x perp. But x perp, by construction, is perpendicular to v. So the inner product of v with x perp is 0. And we're left with c being the inner product of v with x divided by the inner product of v with v. And that gives us that x parallel is the inner product of v with x over the inner product of v with v, that's c, times v. And we can put the v on this side because everything else is just a number. And we can express everything else as an operator. See, all of this is an operator. It's take the inner product with v, multiply the result by v, and divide by the squared length of v. So we call this whole thing the projection onto v. And x perp is whatever is left over. OK. So let's work an example. In this example, we'll work in R3 with the usual inner product. And we'll take x to be 3, 5, 1, and v to be 1, negative 1, 0. So the inner product of v with x is 3 minus 5, that's negative 2. Inner product of v with v is 1 squared plus negative 1 squared, which is 2. And so x parallel is negative 2 over 2 times v, so that's negative v, so that's negative 1, 1, 0. And x perp is what's left over. X perp is 3, 5, 1 minus negative 1, 1, 0, which is 4, 4, 1. And you see that, in fact, if you break it down this way, the thing that's left over is perpendicular to v, and the thing that's and x parallel is parallel to v. Okay? And our operator that gave us projection onto v was the outer product of v with itself divided by the length squared. The outer product gives us this matrix. The inner product is 2, so it's 1 half of this matrix. Another way of expressing the whole thing is that the way we got x parallel is we multiplied 3, 5, 1 by this matrix, and the result is negative 1, 1, 0. Okay, so now we know how to project onto one vector. Now we want to see about how to project onto multiple vectors. And for this, we need the multiple vectors to be orthogonal. What I'm going to tell you does not work if the vectors are not orthogonal. So we want to decompose a vector x as some linear combination of the b1 through bk plus a piece that's left over that's perpendicular to all of them. Okay, so here's a picture. Here's a two-dimensional picture if k is 2. You want to take your vector x and write it as something b1 plus something b2. In fact, you might call x parallel this whole piece. The combinations of the b's, we'll call that x parallel. And then you have the piece that's perpendicular to all the b's, and we'll call that x perp. Okay, and we want to figure out what are all the c's. And if we can figure out all these constants, then we can figure out what this part is. Subtract it off, we've got this part. So once again, we take inner products. If you take the inner product of bj with this whole equation, Well, the inner product of bj with x, the inner product of bj with b1 is 0 because they were orthogonal. All the terms here are 0 except for bj dotted into itself. And bj dotted into x perp is 0 because x perp was perpendicular from everything else. And so that gives us our coefficients. It's the same formula we've seen before. And the portion of x in the bj direction is exactly the projection operator acting on x. It's the same operation we've seen before. Dotted into bj, multiply by bj, divide by the squared length of bj. And x perp is whatever is left over when you start with x and subtract off all of these projections. So here's an example. In R3, we'll think about the plane that's spanned by b1 and b2. And we'll take our vector 3, 5, 1, the same one we were dealing with before, and we want to see how much of 3, 5, 1 is in the plane spanned by b1 and b2, and how much is perpendicular. So we take the projection onto b1. We already did that. That was negative 1, 1, 0. We take the projection onto b2. Inner product of b2 with x is 3 plus 5 plus 1, that's 9. Inner product of b2 with itself is 1 plus 1 plus 1, that's 3. So this ratio is 9/3 of b2, so that's 3b2, so it's 3, 3, 3. So x perp is whatever is left over after you subtract off the piece along b1 and the piece along b2, and what's left over is 1, 1, negative 2. Or to put another way, we've written 3, 5, 1 as the piece along B1 plus the piece along B2 plus the piece that's perpendicular to both. And that's it. That's how to project onto a plane that's spanned by an orthogonal set.